Hello students, now today let's continue the chapter life processes. Earlier I have explained how do the nutrition occur in the plants. Now today we will discuss how do the nutrition occur in animals. Okay, so there are the five steps involved in the nutrition. The first step is ingestion. Second step is digestion. Third step is absorption and the fourth step is assimilation and the last step is that is egestion. Fine. So students, these are the five steps which involve in nutrition. Let's discuss what is the role of these steps. Students, ingestion means the taking of the food which we take, fine, through the mouth. So ingestion, it is the process where we take the food. Second, digestion, as we know, digestion, this is the process where the complex substances break down into the simpler substances. Third, absorption. Students, the digested food which passes through the intestinal wall and enters into the blood stream. Clear? Assimilation, the food where either you can say the absorbed food which is received by our body, yeah, which is taken up by our body to provide us energy, growth and repairing our body cells. Then egestion, as we know, the unwanted undigested food removed from our body. So these are the five steps which involve in the process of the nutrition. So let's start the nutrition which occur in human through the human digestive system. Human digestive system, in that system the organs are present and all organ together form the alimentary canal, either you can say gut. Fine. Now let's start the part of the digestive system. Fine. First of all, I am going to discuss the part of the human digestive system. Students, this is the part of mouth. And here the mouth cavity is present. So mouth cavity. In the mouth, there are salivary glands present. Salivary gland. Clear, students? After then, this is the part of the pharynx. Is it clear? This is a windpipe. And it is a food pipe which is known as esophagus. Clear, students? After then, this is the part of the liver. This one is stomach. It's a pancreas. This one gallbladder. It's a large intestine. This one is small intestine. This one the part of the student's rectum. And this is the part of anus. Students, all organs which are present in digestive systems form the alimentary canal. What is alimentary canal, which is also known as gut. Okay, now let's discuss how the digestion occurs in human. Fine. So student, digestion starts from the part of the mouth. Clear? Where we take the food. The ingestion process occurs where the taking of the food. Fine. The taking of the food, that is known as the process of ingestion. In mouth, we take the food. In mouth, students, the teeth and tongue are present. Salivary glands are present. Teeth helps to grind and chew the food. tongue helps to rolling the food, tasting the food, and the presence of salivary gland which secrete the saliva. Fine. And here the students, whatever we take the food, the saliva is there, saliva mix with our food, and salivary amylase is present which break the starch into sugar. What here? The starch into sugar. This is the function of the students, salivary amylase. It is a enzyme which is present in salivary gland. Clear? After the students, the digested food enters through the pharynx into the esophagus. Students, through the pharynx it enters into the esophagus. Esophagus, which is known as the food pipe, and food pipe is present behind the windpipe. Suppose this is a windpipe, okay, and it is present behind the windpipe. Okay, so this is a esophagus. It is a esophagus part. Here, students, epiglottis are present. What is the function of the epiglottis? Epiglottis, the function of the epiglottis to pass the food in food pipe. Why? Because it does not go in the windpipe. It is just like this. Epiglottis, when the food come, suppose this is my hand and epiglottis is firstly in this stage. When the food enters, epiglottis turn. Fine. And the food enters in the esophagus. After then, students, in esophagus that in the food passes in stomach, but there is the movement occur which has to pass the food. That is peristaltic movement. What is it? Is peristaltic movement. Fine. What is peristaltic movement? Peristaltic movements means the contraction and expansion of the muscles. So the food pass through from one part to another part through the peristaltic movement, where the contraction and expansion of the muscles occur. Now the food enters in stomach. Students, in stomach there are the three gastric glands are present. Tubular gastric glands are present, and these tubular gastric glands which secreted the gastric juice, and these juice are, students, I'm writing here, so stomach. Now students, here in the stomach, three gastric juices are present, and here pepsin, HCl and mucus. Pepsin, which breaks the proteins into peptones. HCl, where the medium it will be acidic, and that's why the function of the main HCl is to kill the bacteria which is present in our food. And mucus, which protects us from the inner wall of the muscles. Fine, students. Now students, let's see here. After three to four hours, the food enters in small intestine. Here, students, in small intestine, receive the juices from pancreas and liver. Is it clear? From pancreas and liver. Now, students, liver, which is the largest gland part of our body. Fine. Now, here, students, liver and here gallbladder is there. Liver secrete the bile, and this bile it collects in gallbladder. This is the gallbladder, and that gallbladder secretes the bile juice through the bile duct and enters into the small intestine. Clear? Pancreas secretes the pancreatic juice, which is also received by the small intestine to digest the food. Okay. Now here, students, the intestinal enzymes are present, and the intestinal enzymes which helps to convert the carbohydrate into glucose, fats into fatty acids, and proteins into amino acids. Now, students, that intestinal juice means that pancreatic juice contain the two type of enzyme which is known as lipase and second one is trypsin. Fine, pancreatic juice two, one is lipase and another is trypsin. The main function of trypsin is students that it converts the protein into peptones. Trypsin work on the protein and proteins convert into the peptones. Is it clear? After that, students, the lipase act on fat. Okay, and the fats converted into the fatty acids and glycerol. Fine. Now, students, that lipase and trypsin, there is an important role in the digestion of the food. Now, the complete digestion occur in the small intestine, and here the inner lining of the wall, there are the villi present. Villi, which is the finger-like projection, which is so many villi are present in the inner wall of the inner lining of the small intestine. Fine, and villi, which is a finger-like projection, and here blood capillaries is there. So here, students, the food completely digested, and it is the process known as the absorption, where the digested food passes through the inner lining of wall and enters into the blood stream. Now, students, that digested food which is absorbed by the cells of the body for energy, for growth and the repairing of the cell. Okay, and undigested food which comes in large intestine, and after then the water which is absorbed by the villi, and the undigested food which enters through the large intestine into the rectum, and in rectum it collects, and by the anus it is expelled out and excrete from the body. So this is the process of the nutrition in human beings through the digestive system, where the main important part of the enzymes and that juices which secrete in the large intestine and secrete in the pancreas and stomach in the small intestine also, which breaks the complex food into the simpler food. Okay, students, so this is the human digestive system. Thank you.